China and Russia visa waivers, our topic tonight. Let's go straight to Patrick from Jigo. Patrick.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening. Half a day.
I understand, Guam is a gateway to Asia. But Guam is also, where America's day begins, and it's also the first line of defense, for any U.S. soil. So, I believe, by allowing this China-Russia visa waiver, that kind of makes us no longer earn the title. See what I'm saying? Guam will no longer considered the first line of defense for the U.S. because, we're opening the doors to the, China-Russia, for tourists to come in. So, I understand that, GVB is trying to find ways to, bring, tourists, to Guam. But, we have to focus on countries that are neutral, with the U.S. See what I'm saying? And, allowing, communist people to arrive on our island kind of makes, it makes the people here kind of uneasy. See what I'm saying?
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Great. Thank you for that comment. And you're gonna have that. You're gonna have that. We get them now in regards to the charter flights as well right now, right?
Yeah. It's and what we're asking for is it's not like Chinese can't come to Guam right now. What they have to do though is they have to go through this very extensive and expensive visa process that takes anywhere from 120 days. There's only five places in the country where they have to go where they can get a visa. So you actually have to go apply for your visa at an office. And then you have to make an appointment to come back to that office. So you might have to travel by train or plane to just fill out the application, then go back later, a couple months later, and then do an interview. We're the only country right now that makes China go through the interview process, all these other countries. And I understand, of course, national security, but I mean, as far as I know, China is our trading partner. I mean, we buy all our iPads and iPods from China, and we're doing a lot of trading with them. And part of what the U.S. is also looking at, they're going to be increasing the number of visas issued to Chinese overall to promote travel. There's an imbalance and the trade imbalance with China, right? We're buying more from them, so we'd like them to come to the U.S. and experience American products, spend their money in the U.S. and try to even out the trade imbalance.
Let me ask you this. I mean, definitely as the gentleman's concerns, very legitimate concerns, and those are the concerns that some of the obstacles actually that you're going to have to tackle. But likewise, we have a market here as well. I know over the years the folks have been trying to get the Guam-only visa waiver for the Philippines. And I know the U.S. Homeland Security has again, their concerns about Filipinos coming to Guam, and basically it's an overstay issue.
Overstay
issue. This is a national security concern. So, if an overstay is having a hard time getting a visa, what more with a national security concern? You know what I'm saying? I mean, when you're looking at them as, hey, look, I would rather give you maybe the possibility of an overstay than maybe of a national security concern. So,
that's kind of our thinking, though. I mean, I'm not an expert in national security, but right now, Chinese can come to Guam. Mm-hmm. They can go through the visa process. Mm-hmm. So I'm sure if they wanted to come here, those who
ill intent.
would be able to figure out a way to get her. The other thing, Hong Kong is a visa country.
Country, yeah.
Okay, Hong Kong is the passport system is controlled by mainland China. So I think people if they want to come to Guam, they would be able to. And I think the key is to work with Homeland Security and DOD to look at these concerns and see how we can mitigate it, work together, and see how we can bring down some of the concerns. Because in order for our tourism and our economy as a whole to grow, we need to tap into this new market.
An emerging market, sure.
Yeah, it's an emerging market. I mean, Japan market is going to be on the decline. I mean, with their declining population and their economy is a bit stagnant. So we're going to need to tap into other markets, and China is a natural fit for Guam. And it'll be a great boom for our economy.
My understanding, Chinese tourists and Russian tourists stay a little longer, spend a little more. Those markets, at least what you're going after, are higher end markets at this point, right?
Yeah, we're definitely targeting the higher end market, trying to get that high spending Chinese.
Are you looking to target, because now there are U.S. airlines that definitely fly into China based on them being allowed to they open up their skies pretty much, not completely, but they have opened up their skies. Are you looking to get these markets, these Chinese, to be able to fly U.S. airlines?
Right now we're working with Continental on a lot of these charters, mainly coming from Shanghai. But and they've expressed to us, both Continental and Delta, that if we could get the visa waiver, they'd be interested in doing a direct service between Guam and and China. Mm-hmm. The other thing that's interesting is for the region as a whole, and the reason why, I mean, there was a law passed to include China and mm-hmm. Russia into a visa waiver program. Under the old Guam-only visa waiver program, yeah. mm-hmm. We would be accepting Chinese and Russians right now if we just kept with the old law. But they decided to combine it with CNMI, and the intent of the law was to combine the region.
Well, that law also was also trying to do a Guam-only Philippine visa waiver as well.
Yeah,
they were trying to do that. What the effort? How are the efforts in the Philippine visa waiver? How's that coming?
I mean, that's a tough one because of overstays, and I don't know if they would qualify under that. There's a percentage mm-hmm. of overstays and different things, but so that's something where you know that's a tough one. So we're just really trying to focus on the China and Russia part
I would assume that an overstay would be easier to track than maybe someone who has. As a ill intent.
Yeah, so, I mean, that's anyway. A possibility, but yeah. But the other thing for the region, though, mm-hmm. Because CNMI right now there's no direct service between them and China because, you know, how the airlines work, it's a hub and spoke method.
Sure,
you need
sure.
that critical mass to draw daily service. So, sure. So for the whole region as a whole, it's important if Guam was able to get China and Russia on the mm-hmm. visa waiver, where we can have direct service coming to Guam, and then they can spoke out into the other islands mm-hmm. of Micronesia.